We have my almost runner rack right here. Presto's acronym. I've got two pairs. Most comfy shoes I own. The HTM Lunar Chukka. These are amazing. These are some of the first shoes I ever actually wore and rocked a lot. I have a green pair tucked away on the other side over there. I'm a big Reigning Champ guy, so I bought a lot of their collabs, their New Balance. Big fan of the brand, so I rock a lot of their clothes. So when they did the A6 and the New Balance, they were both pairs I had to have. I love my sock darts. You almost don't even feel like you have them on. The Roshi days. I've got the Yeezys. I remember getting these in New York. These were actually surprisingly hard to get, and these barely fit me. I think they're like 10 and a half, and they're really snug, but I just had to have them. This is what happens when you don't take care of your Boost, and you don't clean it, and you don't wipe it down, and you just wear it. They yellow, they get dirty, the stain becomes pretty much permanent. I bought these in 2014, so these are probably the first pair of Boost I really owned, or anyone really owned, but I've beat them to shit at this point. These are the Roshi Run Mid from the City Pack. This one's from Paris. I think I got these in Vegas, and I was just, this was when the Roshi was the hottest shoe on the market, so I still think it's a great silhouette, especially this mid-cut in this colorway too. These are officially slept on and should have been purchased by everyone. The All-Star ones, they're beautiful. Some of my favorite Jordans that I own, they look great on foot. Undefeated Dunks, these, oh, I love these. 1985 on one side, Nike on the other side. Just Do It, it's just some of the best Dunks anyone could really own. These are pretty rare, I just snagged them on eBay. I couldn't help but to grab them, especially when it was pretty much retail pricing. And then these Roshi runs are really hard to get. I was lucky enough to get them at the time. I haven't really worn them that much because they're so white and it's tough, but they're beautiful. These A6 boots are great for winter. I grabbed these from Sam Tabac, I think. They're the only place that carried these. And it's surprising how many Canadian stores don't really have A6, but this is a great looking shoe. Nice Oreo colorway. Perfect for the winter. Waterproof. It's a great Vancouver pair of kicks. Presto Utility. Anywhere, if you live anywhere with rain, even some snow if it's not too bad, these are amazing. Waterproof, keep your feet decently warm, but they're perfect for Vancouver, almost a must have. And I think a lot of people copy these after I hyped them up a little bit. Right here is Adidas Consortium collab, Goodfoot Huff and Undefeated from 2009. This is probably one of the first like sneakers I really bought. After I graduated, and they're really beat up now, and I don't think a lot of people remember Goodfoot. They've closed down since, but these are pretty classic, to me at least. This is my basketball rotation. Been playing in the LeBron 14s, great shoe, full zoom units. Same with the Jordan 31s, these are the All-Stars. I just love how the All-Stars this year came out, all of them with the kind of chameleon look. They look great on court. PG1s. I don't think you can beat that for 145. And the Kyrie 3. Black History Month. It's my rotation for basketball. It depends what kind of mood I'm in when I'm playing. This is my Boost row here. I've got 3 NMDs, 3 Ultra Boosts, and a Pure Boost. The City Socks, as soon as I saw these when they first came out, I was in love. Had to have them. They're probably the most comfortable NMD just because of the upper being sock-like. Same sole. But I had to add my own insole. This is key. If you're buying NMDs, add your own insoles. It makes it a lot more comfortable. I was surprised to find out, these didn't release in Canada, I got them in the US. I was surprised to find out these are going for like $1,000 on StockX right now, which is crazy. But easily one of my favorite NMDs in pretty much anything Adidas has done because of the prime knit pattern. I feel like a lot of the patterns they've done lately haven't been doing it for me, and these really came out great. And then the classic NMD OG, picked them up this year, they're not the 2015 version, but still great shoe to have in the collection. Kith mids, impossible to get on without a shoehorn. I've got them stretching here, but you know, it's an Ultra Boost, it's really comfortable. I love the pattern on these too, and this was a must have. I'm a big fan of Kith, and and the work they do. And then livestock, Vancouver's very own. These came out great. The Pure Boost from last year wasn't that well received because of the design, but I think livestock came in and just like made these perfect. They're very, really rockable. They look great, great detailing, lace tips. Just great design all around from them. Triple Black Ultra Boost. So these were a must have as far as the boost goes for me. This is mostly dedicated to my Jordans, these two rows here. Van ones, I wish I had picked up two pairs last year. Lesson learned. These are the Quad 54s. These only released in Europe, I'm pretty sure, and I got them in Paris the day before release. Look at those. That Wings logo. True Blue 3s, Summit 4s, Oreo 5s. These are one of the first Jordans I ever bought. They have a lot of meaning to me. Wore them a lot when I traveled to New York. So this is a pair I'm always going to really love. I think my favorite silhouette from Jordan is the Jordan 7. It's my favorite looking shoe. I have more Jordan 7s than I think any other silhouette in my collection. These are from the Gold Moments pack, so I also have the 6s that came with them. Both great looking shoes. Take Flight 8s that just released. Amazing. Royalty 4s. I mean, if you didn't grab these, you're going to regret it. Look at that gold shimmer. I love them. Space Jams. These two pairs here are from some of my favorite brands, Wings Plus Horns leather, high top, great premium leather, made in Italy. Yeah, great looking shoe. I call these my date night shoes. So I gotta dress up fancy. These are from John Elliott, leather high top. I just love the look of both of these. More SF Air Force One camos. Another pair of sevens, from the Champagne pack. My Legend Blue. These are clean. And then finally in this rack, I've got my Jordan 9 Space Jam, as they call them, but they're more the OGs. These were a must-have for me. The Cyber Monday 3s, the leather on these is buttery. I think a lot of people slept on these last year. There was a lot going on, but I'm really happy to have these in my collection. They look great on, they're clean. And another pair of Jordan 7s, I love these. I love the design of them, the ugly sweater look. My Jordan 10, not OVOs, but NYCs. Pretty much the same shoe without the hype, in my opinion. Another pair of Jordan 7s. These are the Barcelona Knights. I think inspired by the Olympics. I've traveled a lot, so a lot of the shoes I buy, I tend to get suckered into things that have ties to cities around the world. So, you know, these really resonated with me well, and I love the color blocking. So I've got two display cases in my office with some of my most prized pickups. Yeezy 750 chocolate. I think those are probably the best colorway that released out of them. They look great. Material is amazing. And then you've got the Jordan 5 Take Flights. I was unsure about grabbing these because of the price tag, but once they came in and I saw the quality, I was really impressed. I think they're going to age really well and look great with time and wear, as long as I take care of them. Got my Yeezys, my Pirate Blacks that I got from 2015, I'm pretty sure. And the new Breads, I've got those displayed together. I'm running out of space and they look well together. And then finally at the bottom, some more version 2s. The OG version 2 Beluga and the, yeah, this is my Heat. And then the display case to rule them all. This is my Nike Air Yeezy 2s. I don't think I really need to do too much explaining about these. These are grails. I will forever hold on to these, and you know, I'm a big Kanye fan. I remember him wearing the other colorways of these, and when I got an opportunity to grab these, I had to jump on them. They're amazing. Acronym, the Downtown Air Force Ones. I had to grab both pairs. I'm a big fan of the brand and the collabs they've done, and I just think these shoes look really cool and different. My OG Black Gum SF Air Force Ones that came with the tote bag, or the bag. Amazing. I think the design, they killed it on those. OVO 12s. You know, I don't have that many 12s in my collection, but those were an easy pickup for me. Shout out to the follower who helped me get them at retail, plugging me. this is really where Kicksteals happens. The US, Canada, our Twitter accounts at kicksteals.ca, all our social media. We've also got an office in New York City, but this is the Canadian headquarters right here. This is where I do all my work, have all my favorite things, all my favorite sneakers, and where I really can kind of call my little lair for sneakers.
Lollapalooza was where we founded Kicksteals. It was, I'm pretty sure it was the 6th of August when we came up with the idea, and by the 7th I'd bought the domain name, and then that November of 2011 we launched the website. Here we are, we're coming up on 6 years.
Yeah, this is the Kicksteals CA office, and we are going to set up and do a podcast now. Talk about sneakers, go a deep dive into everything.